In this part, we'll discuss some macroeconomic variables and their relationship to the business cycle facts. Okay, so here we can categorize the macroeconomic variables from different perspectives or the dimensions. Number one, if we see the dimension of the macroeconomic variable. So here there are three types of variable. First is called the procyclical. Procyclical means if the economy, the variables, these macroeconomic variables moves in the same direction of the business cycle facts. That means whenever there is economic upswing, these activities will also expand. These variables will also expand, their value will increase. And whenever there is a recession in the economy or the downturn in the economy, their value will also be decreasing. These type of variables are known as procyclical variables. So next is the countercyclical variables. That means the variables move in the opposite direction of the business cycle facts. So whenever there is economic expansion, the value of such variables will decline. So whenever there is economic contraction, the value of such variables will increase in the economy. So these are called the countercyclical variables, moving in the opposite direction of economic activities. And there are some variables which are acyclical. They have no relationship or they don't exhibit any particular pattern of change along with the business cycle facts. A type of classification which is mainly based on the relative speed. So here are some variables. First one is the leading variables. So in leading variables, what we see that these variables move faster than the business cycle facts or the faster than the overall expansion or contraction of economic activities. Sometimes what happens, this variable, change in these variables can also bring about the economic fluctuations. Sometimes what the economists and policymaker used to observe, observe the movement of such variables to find out, to determine or to predict whether there is a business, anything is happening, whether the expansion economy is expanding or whether the economy is going to decline or the economy is going to contract. Okay, so we have in the next page, I have sent a document through which you can have a clear idea about this. Second thing is what the coincident variable. So these variables change along with the pace. They maintain a particular pace with the business overall economic activities. So whenever there is a peak in the economy, the value of the variables are also at peak. So whenever there is a downturn in the economy, the value of the variables falls in the same direction and same speed. So these are called the coincident variable. And third type of variable is called lagging variable. So what will happen? First, the economy reaches its peak. After that, the value of such variable reaches its peak. So whenever the economy falls, the value of the variable falls, but at a slower pace. So that's why we are call it lagging variable. It moves slower than the overall economic activities. The economists who work on business cycle facts, they have identified some key variables. So first is the total overall production of the economy. Second is the overall expenditure of the economy. Third is the employment and unemployment. Next fact is the average productivity and real wage. Then money growth and inflation. Inflation means the rate of increase in price, and also the financial variables like rate of interest, the stock prices, etc., etc. Now we come to the production. The production is the basic, it is called the basic indicator of overall economic activities, because whenever the increase in production determines many things, like increase in production determines the GDP, it determines the national income, it determines the employment. So it is a very important variable whenever we are considering the business cycle fact. And it is normally coincident and procyclical in nature. So whenever the business cycle, the economy is expanding, the production of the country will also expand, overall production of the country. So it is coincident and it is procyclical. So overall production of the country that determines the pace of business cycle. So it is coincident variable also. But remember, we should remember one thing, that there are several sectors. So all the sectors should not expand or contract at the same speed. So that means the cycle sensitivity, that may differ from one sector to another. But over, whenever we are considering the overall production of the country, that is coincident. But individual production, it may be the leading, it may be lagging variable. So similarly, here normally the economists, they have proved that the sectors, through the empirical survey, they have found that the sectors which produce durable goods, they show strong response to the business cycle fact. And because these durable goods can be stored for a long time. Contrary to this, if we consider the sectors that produce perishable and fast moving goods, they are less sensitive to business cycle facts because these cannot be stored. So expansion and contraction, that is little bit, it is a lagging variable, we can slightly lagging variable. So we can see, but overall production of the country, one thing is to be remembered, that overall production of the country is coincident and procyclical. It moves in the same direction with the overall economic activities and it moves at a same pace. So products, if we consider the total expenditure on the economy, that is also coincident and procyclical in nature. But again, the sensitivity on expenditure, sensitivity of expenditure on different goods, that can vary. So from one sector, from one type of good, that is more sensitive, another type of good is less sensitive. But overall expenditure, that is, we can say that is coincident and procyclical in nature. So similarly, now if we come to the types of goods, we can see that durable goods are more sensitive and the perishable goods, expenditure on perishable goods, that is less sensitive. Same reason, because the durable goods can be stored for a long time and the perishable goods that cannot be stored for a long time. So it takes some time for the production and expenditure to adjust with the speed. So investment spending is more procyclical because whenever the economic activities are expanding, then it is also a good indicator for the investors. So investors will be encouraged more. Similarly, whenever there is economic downturn, that is a bad indicator for the investors. The investors will also reduce their investment. And the government purchase is also procyclical in nature. To be precise, sometimes government purchase, that creates the business cycle facts. So if there is sharp increase in the public expenditure or the government purchase, there will be also high demand and that will expand the economic activities. So private investment and government expenditure, these both are procyclical, and sometimes government expenditure can also bring about the business cycle, especially the expansion of the economy. The unemployment in the economy. So unemployment is basically counter-cyclical. So it is very clear that whenever there is expansion of economic activities, there will be more production. So there will be more demand for labor. So unemployment will fall. So whenever the economic activities are expanding, the unemployment rate or the volume of unemployment will decline in the economy. Similarly, whenever there is contraction in the economy, that means gradually there will be decline in the demand for commodities. So the production, overall production level of the country, that will also decline. So whenever the production declines, that will require less amount of labor, so unemployment will also increase. That's why it is counter-cyclical. But considering the timing, we cannot classify it as the coincident variable or lagging variable or leading variable. Okay, so in this case, what we say that unemployment falls in a slower rate during expansion and it increases at a faster rate during the contraction. But you cannot say unemployment is whether it is procyclical, whether it is coincident, whether it is leading or lagging variable. So actually, there is no proper data. The statisticians and economists, they could not find any proper empirical data which is sufficient to say whether unemployment is coincident or lagging or leading variable. But it is definitely counter-cyclical. So on the other hand, employment is pro-cyclical. So whenever unemployment is counter-cyclical, then the employment is automatically a pro-cyclical variable. So average productivity of labor, that is pro-cyclical, because whenever the economy expands, the productivity, there is more investment and productivity of average productivity of labor increases. And similarly, the average productivity of labor is, it will decline whenever there is recession in the economy or economic downturn. Sometimes decline in average productivity of labor can also create an economic downturn. But when real wage is also mildly pro-cyclical, that whenever there is increase in the economic activities, real wage also increases. And whenever there is the contraction of economic activity, real wage will also contract. Because real wage mainly is, in the as per the neoclassical theory, real wage is determined by the productivity of labor, marginal productivity of labor. So average productivity and marginal productivity is also mildly pro-cyclical. It increases mildly with, shows a mild increase whenever the economy is expanding, and it shows a downturn whenever the economy is contracting. So if we now consider the behavior of money supply in the economy, that is controversial, because there nobody can say whether it is pro-cyclical or counter-cyclical in nature. Because sometimes we find that we cannot find a particular pattern of the growth in money supply with the cyclical fluctuation. And to be contrary to this, we can say whenever there is an expansion in the money supply in the economy, that can boost up the economy. So increase in money supply can lead to an expansion of economic activities, specifically in the short run, and decrease in the money supply can cause a recession in the economy. But if we consider inflation is pro-cyclical, because whenever there is economic boom, the price level also increases. There is an increase in the price level with economic boom, specifically whenever the economic boom is caused by the demand side factors. So gradually the economy expands, and with a lag, the price level also expands. So we can say that inflation is a pro-cyclical variable with a time lag. It takes some time to, the price level takes some time to adjust with the pace of the economy. Now we come to the financial variables of the economy. That first we consider the stock prices. Stock prices are not only pro-cyclical, but they are also leading. So whenever economic activities expand, the investment expands, so the stock prices will also expand at a faster rate. And the stock prices reaches at the peak before the overall economic activities, they reach their peak. But nominal interest rate is also pro-cyclical, and it is a lagging variable. So with the increase in economic activities, because whenever there is increase in expenditure, demand for money will also gradually increase, and the nominal interest rate will increase. So that nominal interest rates, that is just like the pattern of inflation, because demand for, we can say, increases, and also the price level increases, so nominal interest rate increases. But whenever we are coming to the real interest rate, that does not show any kind of cyclical pattern, because it depends upon what is the source of business cycle. If there is the supply side factor, business cycle is caused by the supply side factors, so that time it will be, the real interest rate may show a real interest rate may increase. If it is caused by the demand side factors, then the real interest rate may decrease. That depends upon the two things. Real interest rate actually depends upon two things, that nominal interest rate and the rate of inflation. So normally real interest rate is defined by the difference between nominal interest rate and rate of inflation. So that means what will happen to the real interest rate, that will be determined by the rate of growth of nominal interest rate and the rate of growth of rate of inflation. So if the rate of growth of nominal interest rate is more than the rate of growth of inflation, or rate of growth in price level, so that time the real interest rate will rise. And if inflation is greater than the rate of inflation is greater than the rate of increase in nominal interest rate, the real interest rate will decline. So we cannot say anything about the real interest rate, whether it is pro-cyclical or counter-cyclical. It is determined by other variables. So that means that's why we have to consider what is the source of inflation. If there is the source of the business cycle facts. So if it is caused by demand side factors, there will be some different change. If it is caused by supply side factors, there will be some other changes in the real interest rate.